Special programs on BCTV are supported by the following. Keystone Property and Asset Management provides expert care of industrial, office, retail, and medical sites. With more than 4 million square feet managed, Keystone knows how to save you money.
Good evening. Welcome to Diversity of the Water Division. I'm Joseph Amprey, and we have an exciting show this evening. School is out this week, and so we're going to talk about all kinds of great summer activities that our young people can be involved in during this summer. And fortunately, with the pandemic waning, they'll be able to get out. I'm going to introduce my guests to you in alphabetical order. One of whom is here in the studio, and the other two are coming to you via Zoom. I want you first to meet Mr. Richard Bradbury. He's the director of the Olivet Boys and Girls Club Center for the Arts. Mr. Bradbury, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me, Dr. Amprey.
The next person I want you to meet is Ms. Deja Harris. She's vice president for the Olivet Boys and Girls Club. Ms. Harris, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me as well.
The next person I want you to meet is Mr. Stephan Fains, who is the community outreach specialist for BCAP, which is the Berks Community Action Program. Mr. Fains, thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for having me.
And last but not least is Ms. Stacy Taylor, the president of the Reading Chapter of NAACP. Thank you for coming.
Thank you, Dr. Embry. Thank you to everyone. Thank you.
We're going to begin with Mr. Bradbury. Mr. Bradbury is an actor himself, but he runs a fantastic program, Center for the Arts, where they do put on lots of play. Mr. Bradbury, please tell us about the things you're going to be doing this summer.
Well, today was our first day, and we had almost all of our kids there today. Because of COVID, our normal numbers, which are about 33, we dropped them back to 22. So we had 18 of our 22 campers there today. We're starting off with just a lot of getting to know you games. This is the earliest we've ever started camp before, even coming out of a COVID year. So we're doing a lot of getting to know you games, and we're going to have an opportunity to go to the pool. Today, we actually went down to Goggle Works and saw a terrific new art exhibit called, Against the Wind. And I have to give a shout out to Ann Lemon and Mr. Burkhart and the wonderful artwork that their late son has on display and the wonderful hands-on opportunities that are down there. So we went and did that today with our campers, and they absolutely loved it and had a chance to meet Ann Lemon, who put the entire exhibit together with her husband. So we did that. We're going to be going to the pool every week. We're going to be doing some walkable field trips. Tomorrow, we're going down for a tour of the Miller Center. But a shout out from my friend Brett Buckwalter. He's giving us a tour of the Miller Center tomorrow, so the actors have an opportunity. I mean, we have a great little stage at the Center for the Arts, but to get them on the Miller Center stage, I think, is really going to be a thrill for them. So we're taking them down there. So lots of little field trips. And then the last week in June, we start our Face the Music program, thanks to the great folks at Reading Musical Foundation. We will be with six musicians. The kids will all learn guitar, African drumming, and piano, and also vocals from six talented artists over 2 weeks. And then we'll have a show. That's our first show of two. It's a busy summer. And that'll be on July 9th, our Face the Music concert. And very shortly after that, we start our auditions for our musical that we're doing, which is Moana Jr. Moana was just recently out on in the movies, maybe 3 years ago or so, maybe a little more. So we secured the rights to do that. And our cast of 22 will be rehearsing with their director, musical director, choreographer, costumer, set designer, builder, and that goes up on August 11, 12, and 13. We are going to have a reduced audience because we want families, their families, to get in to see them perform live. So the kids may be receiving 2 to 3 tickets. So we'll be between 40 and 60 people at the CFA, in addition to our 22 actors plus our staff. So even then, it'll be quite full during, you know, what Dr. Amprey, you said about the waning days of COVID. So we're just trying our best to stay safe, but still do live theater. It's about time. Sports has been back. It is time for theater to be back.
Well, that is good news. Now, you're full. There's no room for anybody else. Is that correct?
We are full on wait list right now.
Okay, now, I did want to ask a question of Jordan. Jordan, can people call in and ask questions tonight?
They can call in, but the Zoom guests won't be able to hear.
Okay.
So you would have to tell them what to
say. If you have any questions for us, you can call us at 610-378-0426. We're live on Monday the 14th. It is 8:11 now, and we'll be on until about 9 p.m. Again, if you want to call and ask any questions, you can call at 610-378-0426. Mr. Bradbury, thank you very much. Please stay around in case there are any questions about your wonderful program. I want to thank you for what you do. I've had the pleasure of watching you for years, and you
thank you.
A great job with the kids. And also, you're quite an actor yourself, so you teach them what you know, and they're blessed to be able to be involved with theater. I think theater teaches people poise. They talk about speaking. I think it's a great foundation for all kinds of careers. I mean, God bless you.
Yeah, so many lifelong lessons come out of theater. Yeah,
so true. The next person I want you to meet is Miss Deja Harris, who's the vice president for BCAP. I'm always mixing them up. She's vice president for
Olivet,
and she can tell us about some of the other activities Olivet has available. Again, it's Olivet, not BCAP. Ms. Harris, thank you for joining us. What are you guys doing this summer?
Thank you. As Richard Bradbury just said, we started our summer camp today. We have summer camps at all of our locations, the Center for the Arts. We have our Oprah Club, our Clinton Street Club, Mulberry Powell, and Holy Spirit, as well as Pandora. Our summer camp goes from 8:00 in the morning to 5:00 in the evening. We provide our campers with breakfast and lunch provided by, courtesy of Central Hispano. This summer, our main goal was just to get the kids active. We wanted them to be able to interact and just have some socializing time, being as though they have been confined to the house over about the last 18 months. So what our summer camp consists of is fun and partnerships and just interactions. We're gonna have Boy Scouts coming in, Girl Scouts coming in, Million Youth Chess Club coming in. We'll visit our Clinton Street, all the club sites will have one day at our Clinton Street pool. They'll be able to go over there and swim, just let loose and have a good time. Our AmeriCorps program is up and running. So we have a lot of volunteers, ages 17 to 24. They come in and do club service in order to be awarded a scholarship for college at the end. They have up to 7 years to use those funds, and that could be for a trade school, could be for college. So we're just, right now, just trying to give the kids some fun for the summer. We do have to still focus on education, so we do have our Kids Lit program, and we also are running our OJP mentoring program.
Ms. Harris, are you full now? Is room for any others who may not be already involved?
We have room at our Clinton Street location. We have room at Pandora. We have room at Powell, and we have room at Mulberry.
So if someone wants to get involved, what number should they call?
If they can call whichever club site they're interested in signing their children up at.
Is there a main number to call, or should they look
up?
Well,
they can call. I can give our admin number, and then they could be directed to the closest club to their home.
Very good.
So the number that they can call is 610-373-1314.
Again, 610-373-1314, and if they're interested, they can give a call there, and they will direct them to the appropriate individual sites.
Yes.
Thank you for what you do. Our young people are our most important resource, and we need to keep them involved and happy, and I'm so happy they can get out this summer, because last summer was really a bummer of people not being able to get out and get involved in all kinds of activities. Thank you for all you do with our young people.
Thank you.
Please stay around in case there are any questions.
I definitely will.
The next person I want you to meet is Stephan Fains, who is the program coordinator for BCAP.
For BCAP, yep.
And he does a lot of outreach. So tell us about what you guys are doing this
summer. So over at BCAP, we really don't have summer programs. What my job is to do is find those who are having summer programs or want to have summer programs and help them move that along. One thing we will be doing, Deja and I, we've been doing for the past like 2.5 months now, we've started something called the Teen Takeover. And that's, you know, to help combat the violence that's been going on in the city with the youth. Every Saturday from 11 to 4, we were having kids come in, at least 40 kids every Saturday. We had local businesses sponsoring, and we were feeding kids. And starting this Wednesday, actually, we're going to start it up again over at the Clinton Street Olivets from 6 to 8 on Wednesdays. And we'll be doing it at the pool now. And all teens are invited. You don't have to be a Olivet member or something. You just got to be a teen that wants to have fun, free food. Sometimes we have a DJ. Sometimes we have guest speakers. It's been great. It's been great. So that's one thing that I actually do have going on. I just finished up a 6-week teen writing club. We've been doing that for the past 6 weeks as well to try to combat the violence, and that's been great. That just ended on Thursday, and we're going to try to keep that going through the summer. I'll be helping out this weekend, June 19th and June 20th. It'll be the Lonnie Walker basketball tournament, so I'll be helping out with that. Reading Youth Baseball, BCAP actually is sponsoring that now, so we're sponsoring Reading Youth Baseball. So if you're looking for something to do, there's youth baseball games to go watch. The kids are really good. You know, you think you're watching some semi-pros out there, as good as those kids are. It's real competitive. BCAP has tons of grant opportunities available to people out there. So if there's a camp, an art camp, a music camp, anything, we would love to support that and love to help anyone trying to do something like that. So that's what really our job has been, you know, to help everything that's already going on and try to enhance that, try to get the information out there. And just not even for the youth, for adults. The second Saturday of every month, there's a mini stand down for veterans. And that's held in the parking lot down at RAC. And I mean, they give free food, free clothes, and all that to everybody. Veterans first, and then anybody else is allowed to go.
On Saturdays.
The second Saturday of every month. Every month, rain or shine. I mean, they're there. Brand new clothes, brand new boots, blankets, coats, everything. I mean, they do a wonderful job down there. And like I said, if there's anybody out there who needs any type of assistance with the program you're trying to run, especially if you're a nonprofit, feel free to please reach out to me at BCAP, 610-376-6571. My extension is 31. And if I can't help you, I can find somebody who can. All through the summer, I'll be helping out people impacted. If you need hygiene kits, soap, deodorant, lotion, toothbrush, toothpaste, anything like that, I'll be helping the man through my fatherhood program because I'm also the fatherhood coordinator along with the outreach coordinator.
So if they want those, should they call you first or should they come in? What should they do?
If you don't got a phone, just stop in.
Uh-huh.
But if you do have a phone, I would appreciate it if you called and gave me a heads up because I'm a little busy these days.
Uh-huh.
But I mean, if I'm available, I got suits and ties available for guys looking for work. I purchase bus passes for guys,
wow,
things like that through my fatherhood program. I help them get their social security, their birth certificates. So even that for the summer, if you're just somebody that's trying to get back on your feet, I'll be able to help with that. You know, coming out of COVID, I know a lot of people got a lot of issues going on.
Uh-huh.
So over at BCAP, we can help out with all that. Rental assistance, utility assistance. We have family center for counseling families and things like that. So, I mean, we got tons of ways that we can help.
Exciting. Wow. You mentioned a Lonnie Walker youth basketball program?
Yeah, there's going to be, Lonnie Walker's going to be having a tournament this weekend by the Lonnie Walker Foundation. It'll be at City Park June 19th and 20th from 11 to 5.
Uh-huh.
And like I said, I like to help out things going on, so I reached out to them. What do you guys need? Do you need help with the beverages, buying waters and Gatorades for the guys? Sure, I'll take care of that.
Wow.
That way they can take the money they were going to do for that.
Uh-huh.
And do something else with it because it takes all of us. And when those kids see all of us at these types of events, they see that the community works together, so maybe they should start working together. So that's what we try to do over at BCAP.
Well, it's nice to hear that Lonnie's reached back to his hometown.
Oh, man, he does that a lot. He's uh-huh. great with doing that, reaching out home. Uh-huh. He's definitely really good with that.
Well, that's exciting. That yep. is awfully exciting, and thanks for all you do.
No problem.
I
love
it. All these freebies. I mean, my goodness.
There's a lot of stuff out there, man. You just got to look for it. There's a lot.
Give us your number one more time, please.
The number at BCAP, 610-376-6571. 6571. And if you're looking for me directly, it's extension 31.
Thank you very much.
No problem. Thanks for having me.
This is a big week for our NAACP. Ms. Stacy Taylor is here to talk about all the things you're planning this week. Tell us about what you're doing this week, if you would, please.
Okay. Well, thank you, Dr. Amprey, for having me on the show. Like you said, I'm excited about Juneteenth this week. The first order of business for us is this coming Thursday at 6 p.m. It's a virtual program. We will be celebrating the graduating seniors from local high schools through the Dr. Ronald E. Smith Awards and Recognition Banquet. If anyone is interested in getting information on that and would like to see that program to help celebrate these young people that have, you know, achieved their high school diplomas and looking to go forward to a trade school and or a college, I would invite them to be a part of that program. That's this coming Thursday at 6 p.m. It is a virtual program. Then Friday is the kickoff, the first day for Juneteenth. We will open up with 2 o'clock at City Hall. We will have the flag raising ceremony, that of which the city will allow us to raise the flag, and they'll be a part of that. We invite everyone in the community to come out and share this momentous occasion with us, after which we will have a virtual program for Juneteenth that begins at 6 p.m. The information can be found on our Facebook page, and that's Juneteenth 2021, Reading, PA. That program will start at 6 p.m. We'll give you the history of Juneteenth if you're not familiar with, you know, why we celebrate Juneteenth. We'll also recognize local unsung heroes. This year, I'm happy to say that we're going to be giving awards to Mr. Danny Gilmore Sr., you yourself, Dr. Amprey.
Thank you.
Mrs. Patricia Jefferson, along with Mr. Kermit Stern and Mr. Frank McCracken. So we're going to recognize all the good work and efforts that you've given back into our community and the people that you have helped. So we want to say thank you to you. We will have a gospel set from DJ H. Vidal. We'll have some inspirational speakers that evening. The keynote speaker for the evening will be the Reverend Robia Thomas from Union Baptist Church. And then we will have another musical program put on by Sister Elta Henry Jackson from the Rehoboth SDA Church. And then Saturday, we'll have our community family barbecue. That will be on the lawn of the Berks Lodge, number 47, located at 237 Walnut Street. That event will start at 12 noon and will go until 6 p.m. It's free to the community. We will be giving away hamburgers and hot dogs and beverages. We have activities planned for the kids. They will have games. This year, one of our participants will be the Goggle Works. They're coming in and they'll have a glass blowing machine there. They'll be showing them how to seed and pod plants. But I'm so excited because the educational component will be delivered to us by one of the NAACP members, Mr. Alex Seville, and we're going to learn about the Haitian Revolution. So each year when you come to a Juneteenth program, it's our hopes that you walk away having learned something. Over the few years that we've been doing the weekend program, we've learned about the flag and its significance. We've learned that there's a Juneteenth prayer. We've learned about the red pop toast that we celebrate when there is a special occasion. So this year we'll be learning about the Haitian Revolution. We have a couple of keynote speakers on Saturday as well. I'm excited about having Ms. Gina Brown. She's gonna come and deliver 2 poems. She's a young person from the community, along with Mr. Aurora Science and then Miss Neferista Mershuta and Mr. Tillman Sims. They will be our speakers. During the day, they will be collecting books and giving them away to children for the Miss Shirley J. Newton Art and Literacy Foundation. So I'm excited about that and the fact that we get to give our young people some materials that they'll learn about Black culture, Black history. And then let me see, we have a Black business tour. Mr. Winton Butler Sr. put together a history tour for us to find out about all of the different businesses that we've had in the community over the years and some that are still in the community that of which we frequent. So there's a lot going on Saturday. So I invite, like I said, the community to come out and join us for that day. We have the COVID clinic, we have blood pressure screenings, and if you're able to, and it's not a requirement, we're asking people to bring a non-perishable food item that we can give to a local food bank, or bring an item that we can give to the animal shelter. And Sunday, we will close out the celebration with church services at God's Worship and Praise Temple of Spirit and Truth Ministries. That's at 459 Schuylkill Avenue. That will be with Apostle Edna Davis Lewis and the church family. The church services start at 11:30. After the church services, there will be a prayer walk to pray for the gun violence that's in the community, with a light refreshment reception afterwards in the church parking lot. So I've given you a lot of information, but because it's gone so quickly with my time, I would again refer to people to refer to our Juneteenth Facebook page. That's Juneteenth 2021, Reading, PA.
Thank you for all you do for this community. The NAACP has been a godsend. It's been around since 1909. And while it was started in 1909, 10 years later, it was Reading Chapel. Reading Chapel is one of the oldest chapels in the country. Wow. And has always been very much involved with not just black people, but all people of color in terms of making life of, better for them and getting people to come together and celebrate. It's always been involved with voter drives. And every year you have a Freedom Fund banquet. We hope that people will get involved with that. That's a big activity. Some people don't know what Juneteenth is, and you'll get more details if you come out for the program this weekend. But it's celebrated because most people know that the Emancipation Proclamation was issued on January 1st, 1863, and it freed all the slaves who were under control of the Union Army. And of course, the war went on for two more years. But people in Texas didn't know about the freedom until June 19th, 1865. And of course, that has been shortened to Juneteenth. And so was first celebrated in Texas. Now it's celebrated all over the country. And we have had celebrations here for several years, and I think it's so important that people get involved with knowing our history and celebrating the many things that are so important about our history and our people. We think that people who know who they are and what they are happier and reach out to others. I always ask people to love yourself, and loving yourself is not about arrogance. People who love themselves really can be humble, because you can forget about self and reach out to others. If I walk in here telling you I'm all that, I'm this and I'm that, that's a cover-up. Mm-hmm. Because really, humility is about knowing confidently who you are and what you are, and we think that we can celebrate our history. So much of it can be done this weekend with this Juneteenth program. I want to thank all of our guests, because they've all done great things for our community and for our people, and for the importance of getting our young people off the streets and into activities. I know all the things that BCAP makes available, all the things you do for the community, and I'm just amazed at the things that are available.
Trust me, I didn't know either until I started working there. I didn't realize it, and I bump into people every day who, it's almost like you don't know something until you need that help.
Well, I had a long talk with Mr. Fains earlier, a couple of weeks ago, and I was really impressed, because he was a very successful salesman at
Sneaker Villa. Yeah.
And people, salesmen usually are people who work for themselves and can make lots of money for themselves. But his success was based on helping people. That people came back because, how can I help you? Maybe you can't afford this sneaker, you can't afford that sneaker. And then he left this successful salesmanship to go up to BCAP to help people.
To try something new, yeah.
And you were all about giving and helping people.
Yeah, I mean, I was I'm a lucky kid from Redding. You know, my brother's a guy, Danielle Marshall, from Redding, who made it. So I got to see a lot of different things that a lot of other people didn't. So I always tried to make it my business to everything I've ever learned outside of Redding, bring it back home and make home like everywhere else that I like to go. You know, I think we don't realize that. We say, oh, I love Florida. Oh, I love over here. All right, well, the fun time you had there, bring it home and teach people at home how to have that type of good time. And, you know, we can have a better community if we take what we learn other places and just bring it back home. You know, everywhere has their ills and things like that. But there's no place like home, you know, and I'm so thankful that, you know, my boss Larry came into the villa and offered me this job. Uh-huh. You know, I was terrified when he first offered it to me because I'm like, how am I going to do that? You uh-huh. know, but he was like, look, you could do it. You love your community. You love helping people. Uh-huh. Let's go. So I'm from that day, I've gave my 2 weeks. I've been there for 7 years now.
Uh-huh. Well, thank you for all you're doing and for your unselfishness, for caring about thank others. You. And in talking to Mr. Fains, he talked about another person who's very unselfish, who's been around for many years helping, and that's Deja Harris.
Oh, yeah, all the time. That's my partner right there.
And Deja, the thing you said to me that moved me was that oftentimes people come to your office and talk about how tough it's been, how they've been victimized by family members who may have drug problems or victimized by violence. And when they talk about these things, you can talk about having experienced some of the same things. And I think when people yes. know you've been where they've been, they know you understand. And a lot of the experience, tough experiences are something we don't want anybody to go through, but they make you stronger. Mm-hmm. And I love the fact that when people talk about tough experiences, you can say, I've been there, I know how you're feeling, let me help you go through with it. And I love the fact that you said that we do not want to consider ourselves victims, no matter how tough it is. We want yes. to be strong and move forward. And I want you to know that, Ms. Harris, you motivate me with those kinds of concepts.
Thank you.
How long have you been with Olivet?
Next month, July, we'll make 18 years.
Okay, well, all too many of our talented folks leave and don't stick around and stay here and help us. So I'm always happy with folks who stick around and stay and make a difference in our town. Tell me, if you could talk about some people who motivated you over the years, who have been some role models that you really were inspired by?
Oh, man. Well, for one, I would have to start with my mom. Uh-huh. I did share a little bit with you of, you know, our struggles growing up, but my mom instilled a lot of morals and values and just hard work ethic into us. Uh-huh. So I would definitely have to say my mom. And then I'm going to give... Another role model I would say is Dolores Rivera. Uh-huh. She's our former supervisor, and Dolores was tough.
Yeah.
Strong, independent Black woman, very intelligent, and she didn't play any games at all. So uh-huh. she helped us become better employees. So she's always been a role model for me as well. So now I will add on my leader, Chris Winters. Uh-huh. He's a different type of leader. You know, I've been through a couple CEOs throughout my tenure at Olivet. He's one of the most hands-on CEOs that I had the pleasure of working as closely with. He motivates others just like I try to do. And he's one that likes to get into the thick of everything. He doesn't just sit in the office and delegate and you go do this and you go do that. He's on the front line with us. And that's the mindset I'd like to keep. It doesn't matter how many years I've been in Olivet or worked for Olivet, I learn new things all the time. I don't know it all. And there's not one position in there that I will not do. I'll go and shovel the sidewalk if I have to. And he just reassures me that that's okay. You know, you don't have to change because of a title or because of a position. We're here to serve the community. We're here to serve the youth. And that's what really, really, really motivates me, just seeing him do what he does.
So you're inspired by a leader who doesn't say do it. He gets in there with you and does it also. The leader who's hands-on and is involved and doesn't ask you to do anything that he isn't also doing. That's impressive. That's really impressive. It's interesting that they say oftentimes I've tried to hire a star and the star wasn't available, but the star knew somebody else. And so it's interesting how if you meet somebody like Stephan, who's very unselfish and helps people, he says, well, I know another person you can talk to, because I was talking about getting getting Olivet's involved, and he said, well, I know a person, you know, who I go yeah. back with, and you guys go way back together.
I grew up together as kids uh-huh. and everything, yes. and I mean, with the Olivet, I mean, I used to work there as well, so we've just been taking that partnership and utilizing it. We know each other well, we know the city well. Let's fix it. Let's do what we wanted when we were kids. Let's do, and that's all we do. We get together and say, let's do this. And we just, uh-huh. the next day is done. We implement it right away. Yeah, that's my partner right there.
And you're both graduates of Redding High School.
Well, I went to Redding High until 11th grade, uh-huh. and then I moved. I ended up graduating from Mifflin. I graduated from Governor Mifflin. Yeah.
So you know about the suburbs also. You know.
Yeah, yeah. So Mifflin. I know all sides of Redding, and that's another reason why I help and give back, because, you know, I used to be one of those kids that believed the suburbs was different and better. And then I got out there, and I'm like, wait, we don't do a lot of the stuff y'all do in the city. We got more rules than you guys do. It's not this wild, you know? So I got to learn a lot. Like, wait, how come nobody tells that it's this bad out here? You know what I mean? They'll point that finger in the city of Redding, but everywhere else, they don't say nothing. I got to see it don't really work like that.
So the problem's everywhere.
It's everywhere. Uh-huh. And that's what they try to do to us. That's why they keep us in a box. Once you step outside where you're usually at, you'll see that, oh, you do the same things we do? Uh-huh. And everybody's the same. It ain't just you. You know, but sometimes as Redding kids, we take on the stigma and think we're the bad ones. Uh-huh. But everybody's a little bad who doesn't have the education to know better. Mm-hmm. That's anybody anywhere, you know. So I got to see all sides of it.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think the other thing, I think too, we've got to get people of all races to come together and see
for
sure. They have similar problems.
For sure.
One of these I find fascinating in terms of working with both blacks and Hispanics is that we have what we call in the black community something called the one drop rule, so that no matter how much white blood you have, if you have any white blood at all, you are black, even if you have blonde hair and blue eyes. Mm-hmm. And they don't have the same rule in the Hispanic community, so a lot of times it's confusing because you'll see a person who looks just like me, mm-hmm. who happens to be Hispanic, and he wasn't taught that same one drop rule. Mm-hmm. And so oftentimes we have to understand that we all face the same kind of issues, same kind of sometimes lighter versus darker discrimination,
for
but
sure.
We have to understand that the way we identify each other is a little different. Mm-hmm. And of course, you guys work at the, and of course, we are a city which has all kinds of ethnicities.
Man, tons.
We have Asians, we have
tons in Redding.
And of course, I'm so happy that you guys are reaching out and that our young people have something to do this summer in terms of activities. We're happy to see that there are going to be plays and theater, mm-hmm. at the Center for the Arts. We're happy to see that there's a basketball camp with Lonnie Walker. And so happy to see also that the guy who's a Redding graduate has come back.
Mm-hmm. That's important.
And that's this Saturday.
That's this weekend. This Saturday. Yep, Saturday and Sunday.
And that's like the old blacktop, I guess.
Yep, saying. I think that this year there won't be a blacktop, so people are trying to fill that in and throw some tournaments and, you know, still keep that that summer vibe going. Also, as well, the Berks Community Health Center will be doing a pediatric walk-up COVID clinic. So for the kids that are 12, they'll be giving out COVID vaccines. And that's on June 19th, Saturday, June 19th. Uh-huh. So reach out to Berks Community Health Center, and you can get some more information on that.
Well, we want to make certain that nobody feels left out in terms of activities for our young people, and you can reach out. You can reach out to Olivet. You can reach out to Powell Center for the Arts. You can reach out to BCAP. They're all here to serve, and please don't forget the many activities that are planned this weekend with Juneteenth, and let me ask you again, because when you say free food, Ms. Taylor, that always gets me excited. You're saying there's going to be a picnic at the on Saturday? Is that when the picnic will
take place? Yes, sir. We will have the community family barbecue. Uh-huh. We want everyone to come out as a family to have fun, sit down, relax. There's free hamburgers, hot dogs, some other things, pretzels, chips. But most importantly, it's just, you know, having a good time. We have a lot of resource providers from the community. BCAP will be a part of that program.
This
will be on Walnut Street at the where will the picnic take place?
At the Elks Home.
At the Elks Home on Walnut Street. Okay.
Right in back of the Goggle Works. There will be parking on the parking lot for the Goggle Works. The Goggle Works is one of our resource providers this year. We'll have St. Joe's Health there to provide the COVID clinic. We will have the state police there. We will have Redding Public Library, the YMC Library, we'll have the chess club. We'll have COCA there. So there'll be a lot of activities. There's a lot of resource, as Mr. Fains has said, that people aren't aware of what's available to them in the community. So we try to bring all these partners and friends together so that we can share that information.
Well, thank you for all you're doing. We have a few more minutes. If you have any questions at all, you can call us at 610-378-0426. We're live on Monday the 14th. We'll be on for a few more minutes, again, at 610-378-0426. And again, reach out to us if you really have any interests or concerns. Mr. Fains, give us your number again.
610-376-6571. That's BCAP. And if you're looking for me directly, my extension is 31.
Ms. Harris, please give us your number again.
610-373-1314. That's the number to our administration office.
Thank you very much. Before I sign off, I want to thank Mr. Richard Bradbury for coming on and talking about the Center for the Arts. I want to thank Ms. Harris again for coming on and talking about the Olivets. I want to thank Mr. Fains for talking about the BCAP. And I want to thank Ms. Taylor for all you do for the NAACP. Thanks all of you for what you're doing for our community and for being on the program. And I'm going to turn this phone off.
I don't feel as bad that mine went off.
Yeah. Well, I meant to turn it off before I even came here.
Yeah.
Well, thank you. Thanks, everybody. I also want to take this opportunity to thank the people here at the TV station at BCTV for all you do to make this possible. You know, we've been blessed this year because most of our programs up to now have been done what we call via Zoom. And so we can have more guests now because guests who can come from all parts of the country. For example, you know that Mr. Taylor was here via Zoom, and you know that Mr. Bradbury was here via Zoom, and Ms. Harris was here via Zoom. That makes it easier for people to be available. So thank you, BCTV, for all you do to make this possible. It's a blessing that we can just reach out and cover so many bases because of this great technology. I don't understand it, but it works. I call it magic. They tell me it's not magic, that it's logical, but I'm really impressed that they can do these kinds of things. Thank you very much. I'm going to sign off now and thank everybody for participating, and thanks BCTV for making this possible. God bless. Good night. Take care.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming. Good
night.
Thank you.
Good night, everyone.
Good night.
Good night.
Special programs on BCTV are supported by the following. Keystone Property and Asset Management provides expert care of industrial, office, retail, and medical sites. With more than 4 million square feet managed, Keystone knows how to save you money.